Hi everyone, it's Claire here today with the reveal of my August kit for the Wild Hair Kit Club. You are joining me on a fairly miserable grey day here in the UK, but thankfully I have the joy of my new kit in front of me and it is definitely cheering me up. I asked for a petite kit to work with this month. And I specifically requested two of the new Pink Fresh collections, or at least the two of the recent collections. So I've got a mixture of a case of the Blahs, which was kind of spring, summer, and then one of their latest collections, which is Simple and Sweet. I also specifically asked for a repeat of a paper that I had in my June kit, which was one of the Paige Evans Pick Me Up collection. It features a nice neutral on one side and little tiny boats on the other. And I loved that paper so much that I asked for another sheet of it. I also said that obviously if there was any other papers from that collection that I'd be quite happy to receive those in my kit. So what I've got is some of these little pick-me-up swatches instead. I believe that the entire collection has been really, really popular, so there's not much of it left. But Alison has sent me these, and I really like them. I'd kind of forgotten that these swatch books existed. But I really like the idea of them for, like, cards, quick layouts, and then there's a little phrase collection as well, which is absolutely perfect for adding quick titles or little sayings to your cards and things like that. So I've got those from the Pick Me Up collection, and then I've got a good selection of kind of neutrals to work with, which is always good for me, especially when I'm trying to be versatile. I really don't know what I want to be working on. I know I'll work on stuff, but I like to kind of see where my mood takes me, and I'm moody, and I have kind of variable. Sometimes I sit down and I think I want to do a layout, and I end up making a card and things like that. So it's good to keep all of these neutral, and I've got a really nice mix of black and white, but I also like the mix of just different patterns and textures in here. So I've got some florals, some writing, little polkas and grids, obviously some kind of cute icons and some geometric designs. So that's a great selection in and of itself. Love those. I think they're all from Case of the Blahs. And then I've got some 12 by 12 sheets, including a couple of cut aparts, which obviously make this even more versatile for project life, for layouts, for titles, for cards. So I'm really thrilled with this. I love this side. I'm not so keen on the gingham, which actually makes this much easier to use for me, because normally I really like the B side of a cut apart sheet. So that's brilliant. Love this pop of colour in the Good Things from Simple and Sweet. And I quite like the back. I like the chevron too, but this is super, 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 super. I also have more from that collection. This is Good Company. And it's kind of got some little labels on there. I like those. You could cut them apart. You could use them as frames. And I could see this being really popular with anyone that kind of likes stitching or kind of more intricate layouts. I might even use that myself in a kind of rectangular layout. That looks cool. Again, some of the icons from A Case of the Blahs. I love this paper. And I like that tattoo. Win-win. Look at that. Awesome. So this is meh. Yeah. Okay. Exactly. Describing the weather. And then this is gorgeous, but it's got the suckered apart on the back. What do I do? What do I do? I love this. I absolutely love it. So I'm going to have to work out whether I can save some of the back, which is beautiful. I really like these. I don't know what to do now, but hey. And then this is the paper that I requested from the Paige Evans collection. You might remember seeing this in my June kit. I just loved it. So I used some of this on a layout, and this, some of this side, some of the remainder in my mini album, my vacation mini album. It's just fantastic. So I've got loads and loads of paper in my petite kit, right? Seriously. I am genuinely surprised by how much I get in the petite kit. Then I asked for some twine, or some baker's twine. And I've got a selection of colours here. So I've got yellow and a nice pop of orange, and then this kind of grey blue, I guess, maybe cornflower or something like that. And then, now don't die of shock or anything, but I asked for some alphas. I never ask for alphas in my kit because I have quite a lot of thickers that I haven't used. And I also have a lot of kind of medium sized alphas that are quite flat, and I still have to use those up, but I like these. So I asked for a kind of medium set of like puffy or glossy stickers, glossy alphas, and that's exactly what I got. And Alison left me a little note to say that she remembered that I like all caps, because I forgot to tell her. But it is a little weird thing of mine. I do like all caps letters. So she's really, really paid attention to what I do and don't like. If you're a new customer, make sure that you do let Alison know if you've got any weird quibbles, a little bit like me, that, you know, will make it easier for her to curate your kits. These are fabulous. And then I've got these. These are new in the new Simple and Sweet Pinkbrush collection. And they're kind of, I don't know if you can see them very well, but they're kind of textured. So they feel like fabric, a little bit like denim. And they're die cuts. So they're a bit different for me. I really liked using die cuts on my cards and on my layouts. But I've not used anything quite like this, so that's cool. So that's my petite kit for the month. I've got no idea what I'm going to do with it, but I will share whatever I do with it here on this YouTube channel. So please subscribe if you want to see process videos and updates and some tutorials. Do go and have a look at the videos from the rest of the design team. You'll be seeing a lot more videos this month as the new members of the design team join us and receive their first kits. So I'm going to be really interested to see what each of them has requested and how their kits have been tailored for them. It should be fun to see what each person receives and how they feel that's kind of going to work for their style. So do go and check those out. I will leave the links in the description box below, and we will see you soon. Okay.